Hello, you guys. Welcome back to my channel.
Interrupting this vlog from the present day, you know, anytime I'm sitting on the ground that we have some kind of chat to have. So the vlog you're about to watch is a normal vlog. So I'm going to have that after this little announcement here at the front. So just like a big catch up vlog coming ahead, spending a lot of time because I, as I've alluded to in my May reset video, I've just had a crazy few weeks and have been vlogging bits here and there that I can show at the moment. So it's kind of a scattered vlog ahead, but we can get caught up because it's been a minute. But I wanted to get on here at the very beginning to announce that this is gonna be my last vlog on this channel. Just kidding. If you followed around for a minute, then you may have heard me, you know, just thinking about and bringing up, going back and forth on the idea of combining this channel, my vlog channel, with my main channel, which is just called Morgan Yates, if you are not subscribed on that one. And there are people that are for, people that are against, and I've just been weighing the options back and forth for a long time, and I feel like I'm at a place where it makes sense to kind of drop this channel, and which is so weird. It's gonna be like a graveyard of videos. Like, I have some good travel vlogs. I have videos I really like on this channel dating back to like high school, which that's the thing. Like, I made this channel literally in high school, and the thing to do was like people had their main channels with their sit down videos, and then they had their vlog channels. And I feel like as the years have progressed, YouTube has changed. Like, all of my friends that were kind of in the same like YouTube class as me, like we all started at the same time, our videos were very similar. They've progressed to like years ago dropping their vlog channel, and like their main channels or their only channels are very vlog style, lifestyle, and it's like the type of content that really resonates with me, that like I want to make. I've been feeling like, you know, a bad YouTuber, or just like I haven't been able to stay on top of and be consistent with my main channel or with this channel, because it's just like two whole separate things to focus on. I'm not on my main channel sitting down and doing videos talking about 10 lessons I learned doing this, or sitting down and doing these big clothing hauls. Like, I think it makes more sense and feels more natural now to just like, if I have some clothes I bought, show that little haul within a vlog. And so even like today, I'm sitting here thinking about this weekend or next weekend, like what main channel video to put up, and it's, I just am left with nothing. So I truly just don't have enough ideas to like fuel the main channel in the way that it used to be. Not to say it's gonna like be entirely different. It's gonna be very similar to what I've been posting on that channel for a while now, but I haven't been posting every week on that channel. So it's gonna be what's up there now, that continued, and then vlogs coming alongside it. And I know everyone on the main channel may not like vlogs. It's totally fine. Like, those people don't have to watch the vlogs. If you only like vlogs, you don't have to watch videos that may be more sit down structured. The idea of not having two things to try to keep up with, that I feel like I can never fully keep up with, just knowing that if I just combine the two, and we're still posting the same amount, like I would feel like I'm consistent, like, you know, I'm not just behind all the time. The last thing that led me to this decision, and like why now, when I've been thinking about this for so long, is that I have a very big, exciting life change coming up. Like, something that even for main channel viewers who don't really care about vlogs necessarily day to day, like, I think it's big enough that those people are gonna care about it, and at the same time, you guys are gonna care about it. And at the same time, I'm gonna be so busy that like the only content I'm gonna really be able to film for a while is gonna be like kind of vlog style. So then it's the question of, well, do I just put it on my vlog channel and like don't post on my main channel, or do I do that and the opposite, you know? I just think it's the perfect time to be introducing vlogs consistently to that channel, because I think it's something that across the board you guys are gonna hopefully be really excited for. I really am. I'm gonna have my main channel linked just in case you guys aren't subscribed there, but if you are into the vlogs, that is where they're gonna be going forward. Also, just with like, I have a bunch of travel coming up, and I always wanna post my travel vlogs on my main channel, but then I'm like, well, then what do I post on this channel? And then I like split them into two parts and post one on each channel. And I just feel like with the direction YouTube has gone, with like what my life is, what content I really wanna be creating, it just makes sense, again, to do it all in one place. What else did I wanna say in this? So I know people on this channel really like how casual vlogs are, and that's not gonna change. Like, the things I'm talking about, the things I'm sharing, how I'm filming, like, it's not really gonna change. If anything, it's just gonna be better on that channel, because I do want to still up the production value a little bit. Like, I wanna get my cool montages in there, but at the same time, it's not gonna change, like, me and, you know, what I'm saying. The actual substance of the vlog is gonna be the same. So I hope you guys understand this choice. I don't see why it makes that much of a difference to, like, the average viewer because you just catch the same content on the other channel, but I just wanted to make this announcement that this is the last video on this channel, which feels weirdly sad, kind of. Yeah, that is it. We're gonna get on into the rest of this vlog. Like I said, it's kind of scattered all over the place. Thank you all for the love you've shown this channel over the years, like 12 years now, which is crazy. But this isn't goodbye. I'm being dramatic. Literally just scoot on over to the other channel, but let's continue with the vlog and get caught up to the present day from going on a month ago.
Happy Monday. I'm realizing I don't have the most battery on this right now apparently, so I'm just gonna give some quick updates and then we'll really jump into the vlog here in a little bit. I had the most eventful weekend like of my life, I feel like. That's not true, but if things go according to how I hope they will, then this will have been a monumental week in my life. I'm in such a good mood on this Monday morning, even though I've got some work things that are frustrating me a little bit. I'm just like, you know, when just people that work at brands think they know, like, you guys better than I know you guys. You know, it's like, no, you don't. I just spent all this time on a brand deal that I made just like drop. So that's great after I made the whole thing. But anyways, that aside, Friday night, my friend Alana came over. We found a really cute wine bar, which I don't ever really go to like happy hours and things. I feel like if I'm like going out to like meet friends or whatever, it's always like going to a dinner. We stumbled upon this really cute wine bar. They had a really good happy hour, $6 or $7 glasses of wine, which was just awesome. Giselle met up with us. We got sushi for dinner, and at that point we'd had a couple glasses of wine, so we were just feeling ravenous. Like, literally look at this photo I took. Oh, or maybe I have a video clip, I don't recall, but we filled the table with sushi. Like, this place was a buffet. Fortunately, it was very cheap. Oh, my battery's already blinking. Saturday, you guys may remember my love for Renee Rapp. If you don't know who that is, she's on Sex Lives of College Girls. She's a singer. She has great music. I love it. It's like exactly my vibe. I'll put my favorite songs on screen. You can go give them a stream. She is just like rising to fame, like out of nowhere. Had her first songs come out a few months ago. Had like her first concerts a couple months ago, which I discovered her literally like 2 days after she'd been in LA. I had no idea. And so I'm thinking like, when am I gonna see this girl? Cause those were all tiny shows before anyone knew her really. And now I'm like, she's a big deal. I'm gonna be seeing her far away at like some huge venue. And then none other than Captain Crunch, cereal icon, invited me to a Coachella weekend event for the Captain's 60th birthday bash. Now, if you would have told me I was driving out to Palm Springs just for the day to attend this event, I would have said, you're crazy, except Renee was listed on the invite and I was like, I'm gonna be there. So me and Giselle drove over, two of our best friends who also love Renee, so I don't know why we didn't think about like communicating about this. But as we're going over, we found out two of our best friends were also going over for the event. So we just drove separately for no reason, but we got to hang out with them there. Renee performed. I died. We were front row.
I still see your face. I hate hearing your name. What a wreck. What a shame. I'm replaying that day. I get so sick.
Oh, I'm daddy?
Yeah.
Thanks, Ann. Thanks. Much appreciated. Do you have a daddy story?
No,
like literally no, not at all. Just let me drink. Yeah, what's your daddy's?
Leaving, I sprinted across the parking lot because I saw Renee like also leaving the event, like getting in her little ride service thing. I ran across the parking lot and got a photo with her. No chill about it. I'm not delusional enough to think we're gonna be friends, so I was just fangirling it up. Same with Aaliyah, the other, her best friend who's also on Sex Lives. I met her as well. Prior to that, I separately ran up to her and fangirled. Renee was so nice, exactly like what I thought she was gonna be like in person. Just like so chill, casual, like chatty, very sweet. And then Giselle and I drove back from Palm Springs. It was a lot of driving for one Saturday. And then I've been looking for my bronzer for like 4 years.
Welcome to a new day. I keep thinking I'm seeing people like walking by, but it's just my reflection on the glass. You guys, it's been such a crazy past few days. I might not have the most vlogs going up over the next couple of weeks. We're gonna wait and see. At the moment, I'm wearing my Nash shirt that I got on my recent trip to Nashville. I just pulled in to Rumble for a boxing class after like
you know, how many years, 4 years of coming here, I finally bought my own gloves. Here you have to pay to rent gloves. I come so often and I usually know the people working in the front desk that it's not often I get charged. I do occasionally, but recently I've also been going to boxing classes at the place Giselle goes, and there ain't nobody know me. I haven't built my street cred there yet, and they cost more to rent. It's $5 there, so that has been adding up quickly. Bought my cute little gloves. I'll link them below if you're into that. Yeah, I wish I had more to say, but I hate when YouTubers like tell you there's something exciting, but like it has to be secret. Actually, stay tuned. It's just been a great day, and hope all of you guys are having a great week when you see this later tonight. I think our neighbor that we have become friends with, her and her daughter, I think are gonna come over for some margaritas potentially. I mean, her daughter's not gonna drink the margaritas, she's 7, but just a little fun neighborly hang. The weather's been getting warm here. It's definitely feeling summery. Coming up this weekend, I'm hosting a little garden soiree dinner party with Caitlin and Alex and Jill and Connor, so that's gonna be very fun. I'm gonna be making a whole reel and TikTok of all the setup for that. It's gonna be outdoors, and yeah, just lots of fun things on the horizon. Apologies, because these next couple of vlogs are probably gonna be like intermittent clips because my hands are full. I'm very busy, and I have family in town this coming weekend from North Carolina, so I'm gonna walk into this class. All right, what I've been up to the last several hours is packing up some Poshmark orders. Giselle is on her way home from work. She works from home literally like 99.9% of the time. This is only the second time she's been to the office since she started this job. She's gonna pick me up and we're gonna go mail out a bunch of this stuff because it's like a two-person job. So I ordered for free. If you didn't know, you can have the post office deliver shipping materials to your house, or you can get them there. But I'm gonna pack these up. But really quickly, what has consumed the last like 30 minutes of my time that is so wild to me? I was going through my credit card statement because I'm pretty behind on like budgeting and things like that right now. I'm just like tracking everything. And a few weeks ago, Giselle and I went to this really cute restaurant that we had seen all over TikTok. It's a cafe in Topanga Canyon, so over near Malibu. It's called Cafe on 27. It has like beautiful views. The food was really good and we had a great experience. However, it's literally like off of a two-lane road. Like there's nowhere to park unless you are parking in their valet parking lot. It's $7, so for LA, that's like actually pretty reasonable. So paid, didn't get a receipt because I feel like I never get a receipt from valet. I don't think they asked me. But anyways, didn't think another thing about it until I was looking at my credit card statement and I was charged $97. It didn't say the cafe, so it like took me a while to figure out like what this was from. I never had another charge for $7 show up from around that date range, so I know I was overcharged. So I disputed it. This is like a few days ago. The amount was like temporarily removed or whatever. But then the parking company came back and provided proof of purchase, which was literally just showing, it's like their receipt on their end that's saying that they charged me $97. We already know that. Like I was there, you just overcharged me. So I just spent the past 30 minutes trying to contact them. Cannot. Finally heard back from the restaurant confirming that that company, the name of the company is who runs their valet, and confirming what the right amount should be. And he gave me the guy's name at the parking company that like I could actually hopefully get in touch with. So now I need to call him. But I've been typing up a document for American Express to reopen the dispute, because I'm sorry, who in their right mind would park anywhere for $97? Like that is just insane. I can't even believe the company like provided that knowing that like that is wrong. I don't know what happened. Gotta pack this stuff up. It is a new day. My hair's driving me crazy. It is beyond greasy, I am aware. I'm just waiting to wash it for tonight after I get done with all of my sweaty tasks I have to do this morning. Giselle and I are hosting a little summer garden themed dinner party tonight. I think it's gonna be like 85 today, so, which always feels like hotter, I swear. Like, I don't even think that's accurate, but this necklace drives me crazy. It's so cute, but it is like constantly tangled. So right now, before it gets too hot, we're gonna start moving some plants over to the patio. We did already kind of rearrange things yesterday, so I'll show you what it's looking like so far. But since it's gonna be like garden themed, we got a bunch of flowers, but we don't have like tons of plants to like fill the space. And since we're friends with our neighbor, she has tons of plants and said that we could borrow as much as we wanted and just like put them all over the patio. So we're gonna go grab that now. And then I just have lots to do for setup, but I'm not gonna show all the details because I'm turning this into a really cool TikTok and reel and working with a brand who is funding the whole thing. So I don't wanna like leak it all here because it's not gonna go up until May 20th. But in the background as well, we've been watching The Challenge. Have any of you guys watched this? I feel like I don't know anyone of my friends who watches the show, but Giselle found it recently. It's like an old, or I guess they still make it, but it's an MTV show that is now on Paramount Plus. I think there might be like two seasons on either Netflix or Hulu, but it's so good. Car Maria is my favorite, as if that's surprising. But anyways, give you a little preview. So we're going for like all the spring colors. When it comes to the flowers, got these at Trader Joe's. I'm gonna put small arrangements on the table. So I'll just say it. So Ball Mason Jars is sponsoring it. So I'm gonna have like mini displays in the mason jars on the table. And then I'm gonna do some bigger arrangements and bigger vases on side tables throughout the patio. That way there's like pops of color everywhere. So yeah, that is a task. Now you can come on down. I'm just vlogging. Hi, are you excited? And then over here, set out is all of the plates, napkins, everything else I ordered. And oh, I have lots of cool candlesticks.